I'm interested in what did Joe Biden know and when did he know it and what was he thinking at the time this coronavirus came on? Because right now he's looking back and saying, President Trump did everything wrong and I'm the genius. If you'd only listened to me, if I'd only been in charge. So I'm interested in what did Joe Biden say during the, as this came on, and what did the people around him who were advising him say? January 27th, he writes an op-ed, says this is a dangerous disease. And here's my plan. In 2021, after I'm elected, we're going to set up a public health emergency fund. We're going to give the president the power to declare a pandemic, a disaster emergency, which he already has. And we're going to set up what he called the global health services to help countries around the world. Does any of that sound like this guy was confronting what we were facing at that point? That was the 27th of January. On the 31st, Trump puts in the China ban. And you know what he said? He said, this is a, you know, xenophobic. This is racist. On the 28th, the day, 2 days before, 3 days before Trump puts in the travel ban, Ron Klain, who's a big advisor to him on health issues, says, if he does this, this would be premature. On the 30th, the day before, Zeke Emanuel, who's a top healthcare advisor to him and constantly being heard, says, stop panicking over the prospect of what the coronavirus is going to do. Stop panicking, he says. On the 2nd on the 6th of February, he had an expert, a guy named Erwin Redlenter, said the idea that this is going to be a serious pandemic is not very likely, and the odds of it being a lethal form is negligible. That was the guy advising Joe Biden. On this, the 11th and 13th, we hear again from Klain. Klain says, this is not serious. We don't face a health epidemic. We face a, quote, fear epidemic, attacking President Trump for raising concerns about it unnecessarily. On the 20th, Zeke Emanuel says, this is all an overreaction. We then have Nancy Pelosi go out and say, come to Chinatown. Don't worry about this. That happened on the 23rd. On the 29th, Zeke Emanuel says, you know what? The masks aren't going to work. Don't use a mask. This is the day that the first American dies from coronavirus. And Joe Biden's top advisors on television say, don't worry. Don't go out, run out and get a mask. It's not going to do any good. And then on the 12th, as President Trump is putting in place a travel ban on Europe, Lisa Monaco, a top advisor to Biden, and Biden himself go out and double team on the issue of that European travel ban and say, we don't need to do this. This is premature. We don't hear the word mask from Biden. We don't hear the word social distancing from Biden. We don't hear the idea of a lockdown. We don't even hear the idea of invoking the National Defense Production Act in order to do to get control of the PPE problem that the Biden-Obama administration created by not refilling our stockpiles. We don't hear those until after the middle of March when President Trump is already talking about all of those things. So I'm sitting here saying, here's a guy lecturing the country saying Donald Trump killed people deliberately. And if he'd only listened to me, when he and his people are not saying we need to shut down the economy, we need to have everybody wear a mask, we need to quarantine in place, we need to do this, we need to do that. In fact, they're saying that's a fear epidemic. And the idea that this is going to be a serious pandemic is very unlikely. Final point. This guy is tone deaf. What value is a promise? What's the worth of a president's word? Does he do what he says he's going to do? We have a different philosophy when it comes to giving our word. Well, I remember Joe Biden being that guy who said we got shovel-ready jobs when we were talking about the stimulus bill in 2011. I remember him joining in all of those lies that were told to sell Obamacare. If you like your doctor, you can keep your doctor. If you like your plan, you can keep your plan. I remember, I'm old enough to remember, when he ran for president in 1987 and got kicked out of the race because he was caught plagiarizing his speeches from the Labour Party leader of Great Britain. I even remember when he was running around the countryside saying, I had a full scholarship to Syracuse Law School. I graduated at the top of my class, and it turned out he got a half scholarship for need and was at the near the bottom of his class. I remember when that got caught up. So here's a guy lecturing us about President Trump. And he and I have a different philosophy about what your word means, when he has lied to the American people when he was vice president, and lied to the American people when he first ran for president in 1987, and lied about his academic background and got caught on national television before that. So please, can we have just a little bit of humility? Can we just sort of step back from these grandiose, you know, President Trump deliberately killed people? Can we really, you know, President Trump doesn't know how to tell the truth. We have a different standard of our work. Can we please step back a little bit and look at ourselves first? I mean, this is just over the top.